Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro, welcome to another video. In this video, I'll show you guys a platform which will help you prevent unauthorized use of your video content. So if you are an ad tech platform or if you are a course creator who is basically relying on your video that it gets purchased and you earn the revenue, but there is a strong issue, a big issue, because it can be replicated. Someone can download using extension. There are multiple extensions available to download your video content, and basically they can redistribute your content for free, or they can charge some fraction of that original cost of that course which you have created by putting up a lot of effort, right? So this platform can help you prevent unauthorized use of your video. The traditional video hosting platforms do not provide that level of security. They do not have DRM, which is like digital rights management, but VdoCipher is a platform which will give you a complete security when you are using this platform as a business hosting solution. So if you're a course creator, ad tech platform, then this platform is definitely for you. And in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how you can do that. And if you have a website, let's say you have a WordPress website and you want to embed the video content and you are scared that it can be downloaded using any extension, or someone just like right click and save this video on their laptop and watch that later on, then your issue is completely resolved by using this VdoCipher platform. So guys, let me show you guys the dashboard of VdoCipher and how to basically embed the video to WordPress using the VdoCipher plugin. We can also use iframe and other embedding methods to embed on any of the CRM if you do not have WordPress. If you have like Shopify, BigCommerce, or any others, Wix, for example, if you have any other CMS platform, you can embed those videos on that other CMS as well. And I'm also going to show you the analytics and the features of security which we have and the control which we have on our video content. So guys, that's the dashboard of VdoCipher. And as you can see, I have uploaded this video. But after uploading this video, I get an email that it's being now protected. Now, in order to create this tutorial, I'm recording this video. That's why now when I play this video,
is SEO really dead? With the release of generative AI in Google search, this question is now.
Now you can see that it's just showing black screen and not showing the actual video. The reason why is that it's automatically detecting that I am recording this screen. So due to the security feature which VdoCipher have added, no one can record the video by recording the screen. So they added this protection layer and detected automatically that if someone is recording the screen, they'll just show this black screen. You can hear the audio, but you cannot actually see the video. So that's a pretty cool security feature which you can get from VdoCipher, and you won't be getting that security feature on any other commercially available hosting platforms, right? And the other thing which I'm going to show you guys is that how you can embed this video to our WordPress. So that's the test WordPress tool which I have created in order to show you guys how you can do that. And now I'm going to embed this video. So let's click on embed. It's basically free content video which I uploaded in on my YouTube channel. I just wanted to show you guys that how this VdoCipher platform works and how you can secure your video content. Okay, so first is that I'm going to install this VdoCipher plugin. So let's download this plugin. I'm going to click on download, and then let's upload this plugin to our WordPress. Let's go to the dashboard. I'm assuming you're already logged in. I'm logged into my WordPress backend. I'm going to click on plugins and then click on add new. And from here, click on upload plugin, choose file. And then that's the plugin which I downloaded. Let's upload that. Click on install now. Click on activate plugin. Perfect, our VdoCipher plugin is activated. Now let's configure our plugin. Click here to configure. And here we are going to generate and paste our API secret key. Okay, let's go back to our VdoCipher dashboard. And from here, I'm going to click on this config section of dashboard. So let's open that in a new tab. And here, let's click on API keys and then click on add API key. Okay, our API key has been generated. I'm going to click on this copy secret key. And then I'm going to paste that on my plugin configuration settings. Let's paste it here. And then click on save changes. Perfect, our plugin has been configured. So here we can add the playback speed if we want to add. We can add the player version. We have two player version. And we can also generate a custom media player. And I'm going to show you that setting as well. Okay, let's click on save changes. And now I'm going to embed my video on a new page. So let's embed the video on the sample page. That's my sample page. I'm going to delete everything and embed my video. Okay, let's go back. Click on all pages. And here in the sample page, click on edit. Okay, I'm going to delete everything from here and embed my video. Perfect. So that's the blank page now. Let's click on plus sign. And here, if I search for video, we have this option of VdoCipher showing up in our block editor of WordPress. So click on that. And now all we need is to add our video ID. So let's go back and copy the video ID. So that's our video ID within the short code. So that's our video ID. We can also embed that using the short code. And let's first copy this video ID and then paste it here and then click on save. Great. Let's go back to the sample page and hit refresh. Now you can see that our video is embedded, but when I click on play sign,
is SEO really that with the release of generative AI in Google search, this question is now more relevant than ever.
You can see that our video is not being displayed due to the reason that it's detecting that I am recording the screen. That's why it's not playing the video. Now, if I upload the same video to my WordPress, it's gonna show completely normal, but due to the security features which VdoCipher have added, I won't be able to see that video. Let me show you guys the actual video which I have uploaded. So if I go to the dashboard, let's open that videos in a new tab. So that's the video, right? You can just see the thumbnail but not actually the video due to the VdoCipher security. Let me show you guys the videos which I actually uploaded. So that's the video, that's the 13 MB video which I uploaded.
Is SEO really that with the release of generative AI in Google search, this question is now more relevant than ever?
So this is basically a video related to SEO which I have uploaded on my YouTube channel as a short, and when I uploaded in VdoCipher just to test the platform, I am unable to play that while I have screen recording turned on. So that's the security feature which you will be getting with this platform. So if you are an ed tech or a course creator and you are selling your video content, then this platform is really helpful to add an extra layer of security. Now let's try downloading this video using the online extensions available in Chrome. Okay, so let's try finding out some extension. Chrome extensions to download videos on page. To download videos, I think that's enough. Okay, so here is the video downloader professional. I'm gonna install that extension on my browser to see if it is able to download this video. Okay, so here it is, 4.5 star rating, 219, more than 200k ratings and more than 4.5 star rating. So let's add it to the Chrome and see if it's able to download the video which I embedded on my WordPress website. Okay, let's click on add extension. Okay, this extension has been installed. let's pin that extension. Okay, let's go back to the page, hit refresh. And here's my video. Now you can see it's giving me the video to download. Now let's download and see if it is actually able to download. If it is actually able to download, then I'm gonna report that to VdoCipher that your platform isn't secure enough. So let's click on download to see if it works. Okay, sample VdoCipher. I'm gonna download that on my download folder. Okay, it's downloaded. Now let's play the video. Okay, so as you can see, the video is just black and there is no audio as well. So that was the result by using this, what was the name of extension? Video Download Professional Extension. And there is another file also. Let's try if that has something. So this is 0.68 MB. Let's download that file to see if it has something. Test 2, I'm gonna rename that to Test 2. Okay, now let's open that up. It's 705 KB. Obviously, it's not the video because it's more than 13 MB, the video which I have uploaded here. Now let's see if it actually plays something. Nope. So that's the test to MP4. And you can see that it's not playable. Let's try some other extensions. Video Downloader Plus. So these are the top rated downloading extensions which everyone used to download the videos from the page, and we are testing it out to see if it breaks the security of VdoCipher. Let's add this extension too. Okay, now let's pin that. I'm going to go to that page again, hit refresh. And let's click on this new extension which we downloaded, agree and continue. Nope, it's not showing any video on this page. Let's try hit refreshing again to see if it works. Okay, it just show that it has the video, but it's download 0 MB, download 0 MB. I'm sure it's not gonna work. Let's try one of the file. So I'm just playing the place sign, but nope, nothing happening. Even if I click download your video, a lot of ads. Nope, it's unable to play the video. So that's really cool. You are unable to download the video from extensions, and it also have the embed iframe features as well. So if I go back to the dashboard and if I click on quick embed, we have this feature to embed this using an iframe code. If you have like Shopify, Wix, or any other platform, you can embed using an iframe. And we have expiry setting as well. So if you want to, if you want the code to be expired within like 1 day, 2 day, or even minutes, we have minutes, hours, days, months. We can set the expiry. We can add the country restriction. We can add the domain whitelist. So if we want this iframe code only to be allowed for one single domain, we can add this domain, or we can add multiple domains if we want to allow that. We can also restrict that by IP address, we can restrict that by country. We will be adding ISO code, so here's the list of ISO code for the different countries. We can add our own custom watermark, and once we have all the settings in place, we are just going to click on generate embed code, and here we will have an embed code which we can add to any other platform, like any other CMS. If you have lots of other features in this platform, and if you want me to create another video to go over all of the features in this platform, let me know in the comments below, and I'll definitely create another video for you guys. Until next video, have a great day.